You're returning à la, oui, the shared brain syndrome of the Ballet Embassy across Europe. I mean, gosh dang, yeah, I would love it if the Americas could have one also. You know that. That would be a smart thing to do. Yeah, and coordinate, you know, you had the, you know, your years over there, you had your years over here, and so somehow it all works out that somehow we get, I don't know, bonus points. Yeah, I mean, you worked in the dance world. It's a world, you know, it's an absolute world. It goes around and around. So it kind of qualifies. It's not Dance Europe, it's not America, it's dance world, you know, it's the ballet world. So yeah. I guess with this shared mind syndrome, I'm thinking everyone else is already saying we need a newsletter. We need a newsletter. Understandably, not everybody is going to be needing or partaking of the special, I'll call us, our unique habitation needs. At the diminished prices, but yeah, they are going to be this, and not everybody's going to need it. And so because of this shared habitation status, it doesn't mean you're not, if you don't want to join in, you don't have to live there. You're still a member. Anybody who is a former dancer, they are still a member automatic. You know, anybody who was a member of the state operas houses. So that's why I keep talking. It's a sovereignty of opera houses. So it's a joining together. It's almost like a new monarchy, another monarchy in itself. Because my gosh, it's a cold place. One opera house is a cold place. Another opera house is a cold place. They're cold places. They're government institutions. And after you leave that door, it is a slam. It is a slam, and you feel like you cannot go back. So it is a curse. It's a curse to ever leave. You know, it's a curse. Because then you have to go audition again. You know what I mean? So it led to another one. And I was just like, are you kidding me? So then I have to go and audition again to another one. Just like, can't you remember? I danced over there. No, I have to audition again. You know, so each time it's a fresh audition. It's not like you little get your patty cake in your bank account just because you got the job the first time. It is an endless supply of audition again. If ever you leave one company, you got to go and audition again. So no, it's not a picnic. Alright. No matter what the PK says. A PK means picnic now? I cannot believe this. This is the first time in my life. They say the PK means picnic. Oh, so I'm confused by it. Yeah. Anyway, so there we are. There we are. We're needing a newsletter. Now, because we have so many voices. We have over here we have the Romanians, and over here we have Bulgarians, and over here we have the Czech, and over here we have the Poles, and then we have the English, and then we have my gosh, did you see the new English Sleeping Beauty? Phenomenal. I'm not really one for that much worrying nervosities of the fairies and their steps, because I thought it was a little excessive. But however, I must accolade them on their technique. It was a little overdone on the have-tos. But however, that's just my critique. So I won't push it. I know everybody's proud of it. It's a very beautiful piece, and those costumes, everything. It's quite phenomenal. Smart fairies, very smart little fairies. so there we go. Very good point work. Very good point work. Much better than I've seen before, actually. So they must be doing something. They must be doing something all of a sudden. Must be doing something. What was it I was going to say? Okay. So we have the English, and then we have Americans also. We have all of these people living here in Europe, from the dance houses, from the Stadttheaters, And we're like, okay, so we all fall into this curriculum, we all fall into the journal of we're members, everybody. And I imagine so we need to somehow get the lists, we need to get the lists of all the dancers from each opera house and have that supplied to the embassy itself. We have to have that list of exact names. And now the list of exact names, verifying who is who, well, a lot of it can be done, you know, yeah, that's that person, you know, I know her, or yeah, that's that's somebody. And so you have enough of that going on, we verify who you are, and so you don't have to be doing Don Q's by yourself like I am. So we have this verification process, enough of you. I would say 5 to 10, but you know, yeah, 5 to 10 of you, and that will be the solve. This will be the solve, won't it? What else did I want to say? I want to talk of, the newsletter. And so then we have the French also. They need the French news. So we need all of this translated. So we need like 10 translators. 10 translators. Is that too many? Can oh my gosh, you guys in the East really get me. Can you just pick one language and enjoy it? Can we just have one language over there in the East with all of your little zakalions, whatever? Can we just have one, and maybe that's enough, you know? Because this is ridiculous. I don't want you all have to be translating a stupid newsletter, you know? That's ridiculous. And it will be just something we send out online. But it's not the point. It's not the point that I need. I need every single different dialect, you know. But then there's the Finns, and the Finns are different from the Swedish, and then the Swedish are different from the Norwegians and the Danes, and then of course the Belgian and the Netherlands. So when we get into the Dutch, the Dutch words, we need them also. So, oh, there was another one. We can use Maren. I believe Maren is running Pilates studio. So she could probably be very helpful as a coordinator there. Maybe even helping to run the newsletter, but this type of a thing would be something. So yeah, that's all I can say right now is a newsletter. We need one of those. And what's the deal else? Yeah, I think that's it. That's all for the moment. But, Spanish, I forgot your Spanish, and I forgot your Portuguese, and I forgot your Brazilians, and I forgot, I don't know, I don't actually know if we have any, you know, superior language Swahilis out there, dancing on the Stadt Theater stages, but we might have a Swahilian, and so he maybe, but wait, you know, I'm 9,999 Mr. Swahili. And I don't understand what the newsletter is saying, so maybe he is going to have to have his own translation service. I don't think we have that many Swahilians. No. What else? We have Egyptians. And so with the Egyptians, well, we're the world here, you know it. So with the Egyptians also, that is another language. So this is crazy, it seems like, what kind of a language, and then we have the Arabs also, we have many Arabs that need their funny Cyrillic. So yeah, I don't know, we can have the Arabian, we can have the, and what are the Turks, what are the Turkishes, what is their language? Because we have the Turks, we have many Turks that are dancing. So we have just an endless supply. This one newsletter is becoming like a phenomenal. Is there any translator I can that not me? I cannot do all this, but we can filter through and say this language, that language, another language, and another language, and so we're just like down the line with all of these languages and send it out. And this is the list of persons that wants to hear Turkish. And of what's going on in the ballet right now, across is, you know, our general our votes, our end votes, what's happening, what vote is coming up, that type of thing. So it's going to be kind of similar to if you've ever, you know, used the market, if you've ever traded, It's going to be kind of like one of those your profit share, this is a direction we're going with your mutual fund. So it's not going to be anything, you know, like, hey, everybody, well, sometimes you'll get a death. We'll send you a death. Sure, why not? And another thing, yeah, it'll be like one of those profit share notifications. This is what happened. This is what happened, you know, recently. And this is what's going on, and this is what you can vote on in the future. So yeah, I would like to have that going through. Yeah, so if all 50 of the main persons that work for the Ballet Embassy itself are the major board of directors, and then the others, all 9,000, all 10,000 of you, because I don't think there's very many, if all of you can actually then thusly be just simply waiting for your newsletters, or, you know, the remainder ones, waiting for your newsletters, and then with the newsletters you get your personal mailing list. It has to be somehow a mailing list to the Czechoslovakian wanters, a mailing list to the Polish speaking wanters, a mailing list to the Deutsch, a mailing list to the French, a mailing list to the Russians, and a mailing list to the English, a mailing list to the Spanish. Yeah. So we need to get a list of everybody, and we need to actually, I hate to type you out, everyone, but I have to, you know, what language do you want? So we need to get your names from all the opera houses, and then we need to know what language is your preferred language. And then we start setting up a voting system a little bit more elaborate. So besides the board of directors, the main board of directors of the 50, all of the others will have a vote. And I like that part. I like everybody of us to have a vote. And it's just going to be majority rules, whoever shows up to a certain time interim. You know, if you had, 3 weeks, this is it, everybody. We have 3 weeks to make the vote. And then after that, that's it. It's bust, that's over. So we'll do it that way. And so anyway, what can I say? Sorry, I've been, I don't know. Not dancing too great. I tried the roll-ups today. Those are pretty good for the inner leg muscles, but the shock on the feet, the feet aren't as pointy on the roll-ups. So I didn't put that online. But yeah, they're very good on the point shoes if you wanted to do those by yourself. That was just exercise extra. So yeah, I don't know what to do about the people who have had children and they live with the children still, and they want to be a part of the system, but they don't have any money, and they prefer to be with the 1,000 group that are sharing abodes, sharing hotel space, sharing bed and breakfasts. If they want to be living that way and yet they have the children, I am not sure how to implement that extra, because that's kind of like an extra group duty, you know what I mean? So you're actually going to have to pay somehow a little bit extra because you have the children. I know that's even tougher. It's even tougher for the people. I didn't mean to do that, but you know, they can't, it is, in a way, it's a penalty. You know, it's a penalty. You know, if it's only 200 or 300 a month with our housing, and with paying the bills, and with the car that we all share, then well, as soon as you start adding the children in, they're going to be using all of these things also, and need bedrooms, and so no, it just starts to become really difficult, and so we have to put the people who have the children together, you know, we have to put them together, first of all. And so that little extra bit of money for the children will somehow figure out how to get to them. because we don't want them living in squalor towns. We don't want them living in any kind of trailer houses aside next to the freeways. We don't want any of this going on. I mean, your former performers from the opera houses, I expect you to demand respect right now with me and, in coordination, that you and your children will be raised likewise. Chances are they will be wonderful performers also. So I guess that's enough. That's enough for today. From this Mother Earth here. Anyway. So yeah, you know where I am.